Hello and welcome to this Daughters of Khaine painting video. In this video, we're going to be taking you through how to paint magical effects on your bladed weapons. Most specifically, the heart shard glaive that's carried by the Blood Sisters and the death sword that's wielded by the Slaughter Queens. Though it won't make any difference what undercoat you use, for the purpose of this video, we've used Mechanica Standard Grey. Now the first colour scheme we're going to concentrate on is a purple tinted magical heart shard glaive. Now we're going to start by base coating that with Iron Hand Steel. So first of all, I'm going to grab myself a medium layer brush. Just going to place them on the palette, a little bit of water, not too much, just so it's not too thick and goopy, and then get my brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to go. So what I'm going to do is just start concentrating on the actual blade itself. You might want to do a couple of coats if some of that grey shows through, but one coat should be enough. There we are, that base coat now applied. What we're going to do now is apply the rest of the colours to that blade. We're going to start by using Drutchy Violet, which we're going to thin down with Larmy Medium. So two parts Larmy Medium to one part Drutchy Violet. Then after that, we're just going to highlight the edges of the blade using Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's apply that shade. So what I'm going to do here is get two paintbrushes of Larmy Medium, like so, give that a quick wash, and then one paintbrush of Drutchy Violet. Mix it together. Like so. In some places you might want to do a second coat, but for most of it you're just giving it a bit of a purple tint, if anything. So just apply that over, pulling that on some of the blade edges like so. Also, it's worth just leaving the blade in a vertical position so it pulls closer to the bottom of the blade. That'll give you a nice blend to it as well. There we are, with that shade now dry, what we're going to do now is finish off this blade by highlighting it with Stormhost Silver. So for the most part, I'm just going to use the edge of the brush like so, and just run around the blade just to get a nice consistent line as I'm working along. In some places, what you might need to do is just use the tip of the brush, like I'm just going to do here. So some of these little details just here. Again, just be mindful, take your time, and just work your way down. There we are, with our highlight done. Our first heart shard glaive is done. So what I'm going to do now is move on to our next one. Now for this, we're going to start with Grey Sear as a base coat. We're then going to shade all over using Coelia Green Shade. We're then going to use Grey Sear again as a broad highlight. And then lastly, we'll use White Scar as a fine highlight, and little dots here and there as well. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So I'm just going to get some Grey Sear, apply it to the palette, a little bit of water, just get so it's not too thick and goopy. Get a good point to the brush. And then we're ready to start base coating it. So all I'm going to do is just do a couple of coats. One should be enough, but if you're not sure, always do a second one. Now that we've applied the base coat, what I'm going to do now is move on to using Coelia Green Shade and applying that all over, like so. But I want to leave that to dry for around about 30 minutes. And again, if you want to, just hold it up so it's vertical. So all this shade will then just drop around in these little recesses here and give it a bit of a blend. With the shade dry, what I'm going to do now is use Grey Sear again, and we're just going to highlight around the edges. So what I'm going to do again is just use the edge of the brush like so and work my way around. Take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, you'll need to tidy back up and reapply some Coelia Green Shade. There we are, with that Grey Sear highlight done. What I'm going to do now is finish off with a bit of White Scar. So what I'm going to do is just do little dots here and there on some of the raised areas, or like the top parts of the blade. Just go a little bit with an edge highlight, but not too much, not all the way down, just so far, like so. There we are, with that White Scar highlight now done. What we're going to do now is move on to our final weapon, which is the Death Sword. Now for this, we're going to start off with a Baden Black as a base coat. Then we're going to use a little bit of Mephiston Red. We're just going to work up a bit of a molten effect up the blade. Then we'll use Wild Rider Red to add to that fiery glow, finishing off with a little bit of Iron Hand Steel for some chipping here and there. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So I'm just going to get a dollop or two and just thin it down a little. And again, I'm using my medium layer brush for this as well. Then we'll just pick out that blade. So it's this large one on the side here. So all I'm going to do is just work up the blade itself. Should probably only need one coat because it's black over grey. There we are, with the blade now base coated in black. What we're going to do now is use Mephiston Red. And as opposed to doing like edge highlights and stuff, I'm just going to slowly stipple from the top downwards, starting quite broad and then thinning out. So all I'm going to do by stippling is just stab my brush, just to give it a bit of a dotted effect. I want to keep going back and forth to get some more paint, which gives it a little bit of a molten kind of crackle effect. Just work your way down the blade on both sides doing this. There we are, with that first colour now done, we're going to move on to Wild Rider Red and do something very similar, but just doing a little bit less so you can see a lot of that Mephiston Red showing through. Again, just stabbing around the edges to give it a bit of a fiery crackle effect. Also at this point, I'm not going to go all the way down the blade. I'm probably going to stop about halfway. There we are, with the fire effect now done, we're going to finish the blade off by using some iron hand steel just to do some chipping on the edges of the blade. So again, a bit like we did with the red, just do like little dots here and there. You can move up into the red a bit as well. Just do that on both sides. And if you're really feeling brave, just do some at the center part as well. And there we are with that chipping now done. The Death Sword and the Heartshard Glaives are now finished. Now remember, you can always transfer these colour schemes onto your normal weapons in your Daughters of Khaine collections as well. So there we are. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own magical blades. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.